You're watching Truth vs. Hype. The rape of a young woman in a cab run by the company Uber has exposed the claims of safety made by a new generation of taxi services. But while the government has been quick to ban Uber and companies like it, has it failed to keep the promises of making the streets of Indian cities any safer for women after December the 16th?
A midnight drive that ended in a nightmare. It could have happened in any city, in any form of public transport. But the headlines focused on Uber, the American cab company whose unorthodox approach is shaking up taxi businesses in cities around the world.
Uber and similar companies like Ola don't actually own the cars they operate, but connect customers to available drivers via an app. Click on Uber and it will show you drivers nearby who can reach you within minutes. It's an ingenious model, one that allows them to grow, bypassing existing regulations which insist that taxi operators must own the cars that they run. The flip side is that Uber is not bound by the same safety measures that come with the rules.
Drivers of the black and yellow cabs need police verification before they get a badge. Even the next generation of radio taxis like Meru and EasyCab have to do the same. In fact, they have to do more.
In terms of technology, we have a very robust feature which is called as trip tracker facility. Every person can give somebody else number in their mobile phone as a trip tracker number, and whenever that person will take a trip, the details of that trip would be given to the other person so that somebody else can track that the trip of that person.
Uber claims it has its own safety checks. In fact, it likes to hard sell safety. Its website says it's committed to connecting you to the safest ride on the road, which means setting strict safety standards. Every driver is thoroughly screened through a rigorous process. But then why did Uber have no idea that Shiv Kumar Yadav had multiple offences against him?
And I had to find him.
New offences seem to emerge every day. A woman passenger claims to have reported the driver's unsettling behaviour to Uber.
He kept staring through the mirror and I felt a little uncomfortable, so I would hide behind so he couldn't see me.
They do take your...
By contrast, an Uber driver we interviewed in New York indicated that Uber does insist on police checks, in addition to which it does its own checks.
Now over here, you need a few documents, which is your TLC for hire license, or it could even be the hack license, and you need a car, and also you need insurance, you know, like insurance documentation that's involving you being in a policy yourself, and make sure everything is up to date, and that's about it. And also you need clean records, you know, no criminal records or nothing that could be harmless for Uber to hire you.
So in New York, you need a TLC license?
Yes, you do.
Does Uber do any kind of checks on you, or is it just the TLC?
Yeah, Uber does do, they do a checkup themselves, and also TLC does, you know, a checkup. In order for you to have a TLC license, you need to be clean. You can't have any, you know, criminal records.
Despite repeated requests, Uber kept its officials away from the media, instead saying in a statement that they are evaluating additional screening options to include background checks on all their driver partners in India. The only chance to meet an Uber official was after a meeting between cab services and Mumbai's transport commissioner. But their company's representative tried his best to evade questions.
Can you tell us what safety protocol you follow at the moment?
Sorry, no comment.
What verifications do you do of your drivers?
Okay,
this is very important because people need to know what safety protocols you follow. You're a public service.
These are commercially registered drivers.
So you don't do police verification?
It's a straightforward question. Do you do police verification or not? Your website says that you do stringent background checks on your drivers. I think it's the right of those people of this country to know. What are those background checks?
I have no comment right now.
See, we have some important meetings now to go. Please leave us go.
I think if you simply tell us, one second. Let him just answer a straight question. Yeah, do they do police verification or not?
You can, please, we'll walk out.
This is not a question you can walk away from. To understand how Uber's safety measures worked, we booked rides with Uber drivers in Mumbai. It became clear that there were no checks at all.
Sir, Uber join करने के लिए मुझे office जाना पड़ता पहले. Office जाके वहाँ पे अपना license वगैरह सब देना पड़ता है. फिर उन लोग photo निकालते हैं वहाँ पे. आईडी आपका पासवर्ड देते हैं
और हो गया
उसके बाद बस
हो गया
चालू हो जाता है वहाँ पे
और कुछ वेरिफिकेशन वगैरह मांगते हैं
नहीं वेरिफिकेशन वगैरह तो कुछ नहीं मांगते हैं क्योंकि जो भी है वो ट्रेवल्स के ऊपर है
अच्छा नहीं मतलब जैसे आपको पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन नहीं कराना पड़ता इसके लिए
नहीं सर इसके लिए तो पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन मेरा तो नहीं हुआ था अभी उन लोग कराते हैं या नहीं कराते वो
बट आपकी तरह आपको नहीं आपका मांगा नहीं
नहीं मेरा तो नहीं मांगा था
उबर आपसे क्या क्या मांगता है
ड्राइविंग लाइसेंस की जेरोक्स आईडी प्रूफ एड्रेस प्रूफ
बस इतना ही
और ट्रेनिंग होती है एक दिन की पूरी ट्रेनिंग होती है
तो जैसे कोई पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन हुआ आपका
पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन नहीं हुआ बट उन लोग वहाँ पे पेपर्स वगैरह जो भी है वो रजिस्टर करने वाले हैं मतलब
तो आप फिर कौन से परमिट के साथ चला रहे हैं इसको
सर टी परमिट
मतलब टूरिस्ट परमिट
जी
तो टैक्सी का परमिट नहीं है ये
Tourist permit.
Most Uber drivers, including Yadav, operate on a tourist permit license, much easier to get.
For a tourist permit in Mumbai, a driver does not need a police verification of any kind. In Delhi, however, a police clearance is required, but a much less intensive one. It does not involve a field visit and only entails checking the criminal records of the driver at a local police station, which means if a crime was committed elsewhere, it wouldn't show up on their records.
Yadav got his tourist license by submitting a police character certificate from the Ambedkar Nagar police station. His crime was committed at the other end of Delhi, at the Mehroli police station. Even so, he seems to have gone a step further and obtained a forged certificate through a tout.
You see, as far as this particular verification certificate is concerned, it is definitely a fake verification certificate. But fact of the matter is that this does not mean that there is something wrong with the system. These are, availability of such certificates is a matter of concern. That is why we are now ensuring very professional investigation of this particular case.
If Uber and other app-based services had registered as taxi companies, they would have needed a taxi license. The police verification for it, as these Meru drivers outside Mumbai airport tell us, much more rigorous. Police verification hota hai. Aapka hua hai police verification? Aapka bhi? Aapka bhi hua hai? Verification matlab kya hota hai exactly?
हम लोग जब बैच बनाते हैं ना तो शारदी से पूरा इंक्वायरी होके हम लोग को बैच मिलता है जैसा पासपोर्ट बनाते आप ऐसा तो वैसा मतलब बैच ऐसा नहीं मिलता सब शारदी इंक्वायरी होने के बाद ही मिलता है
अच्छा
कोई रिकॉर्ड है क्या क्या है सब ओके
कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है
बट द ड्राइवर्स देमसेल्व्स एडमिट दैट द सिस्टम ऑफ गेटिंग परमिशंस कैन बी बाईपास्ड
एजेंट का डायरेक्ट
कांटेक्ट हम ले नहीं सकते
पुलिस वालों से आरटीओ वालों से डायरेक्ट कनेक्ट होता है उन लोगों की हमेशा का डायरेक्ट ही बातें होती है तो इसलिए वो दो पैसा ज्यादा लेके जहां पर हमको 350-400 rupees में लाइसेंस मिलना चाहिए 800 rupees में मिलना चाहिए वो 3,500-4,000 rupees लेते हैं तो क्यों लेते हैं तो एजेंट्स इतने क्यों है आरटीओ के बाहर वो एजेंट्स को भगा दो आप डायरेक्टली कर दो क्यों नहीं करते हैं गवर्नमेंट डायरेक्ट करे
तो एजेंट को बेसिकली पैसा देना पड़ता है
एक्स्ट्रा
पैसा देना पड़ता है मतलब उसका समझ सकते हैं उसका मतलब क्या है एक्स्ट्रा पैसा देने का
एजेंट के कोई भी बैच नहीं निकलता
अगर हम आप जाएंगे तो क्यू में खड़ा रहना पड़ेगा वो काम ही नहीं करेंगे बराबर
अच्छा
बोलेंगे अभी नहीं है अभी लंच हो गया कल आओ परसों एजेंट जाएगा ताबड़तोड़ करके आएगा
The regional transport office in Tardeo, one of the three RTOs in the city. Wearing hidden cameras, we approach the agents, pretending to seek a taxi license.
हाँ नहीं मैं actually taxi के batch के लिए पता कर रहा हूँ।
यार बनाने का।
PR होता है ना।
They tell us the list of documents that are needed.
Rishing card, election card, Aadhaar card, school leaving certificate, ye sab leke aao, kya 6 photo leke aao.
But more than one agent admits that at a price, it's easy to bypass the checks.
आप लोग ऑफिस से डायरेक्ट करा के देते हैं क्या?
डायरेक्ट नहीं होते।
अच्छा।
डायरेक्ट कोई नहीं बनाएगा।
कैसे करेंगे फिर?
वो समझाए उसको पूछो।
PR का 3,500 रुपये है।
The agents there will get you a license agents, without any of the documentation. You can literally pay a bribe and get a license.
This is, I won't call a myth, but this is going on probably in circles that this happens. But last 2 months, ever since I have joined, I have started very large scale kind of movement in Maharashtra that this license, so-called license, if it exists or doesn't exist, I don't know, but it should not exist, is going to get eliminated from Maharashtra, and believe me, for this next 2-3 months you will see Maharashtra license free.
In New Delhi, NDTV's Siddharth Pandey found the same bending of rules.
Commercial ka main paper taiyar kar dunga direct dalna, kyunki humse karaoge na, commercial ka rate zyada hai, 8000 rupaye rate hai hamare through.
Thoda kam kar
lo. Certificate hai 10th ka,
main to graduate hai
yaar. Bata kya
main kal singh se graduation kiya hai maine.
तो मैं ही भेजूंगा अपने तरीके से, हमारा इंडिकेशन जाएगा, आप जाओगे काम हो जाएगा,
करा देंगे, ले आना सर्टिफिकेट, ले आना, करा देंगे।
ग्रेजुएट हूं, उसको दिक्कत नहीं, क्या क्या लगाऊंगा मैं, बताओ।
एड्रेस भूल गया ना।
अच्छा, पहले एड्रेस तो चेंज कराना पड़ेगा।
हाँ
है ना, खर्चा कितना बैठ जाएगा?
15,000 रुपये थोड़ा बैठ जाएगा।
क्लास व्लास में जाना पड़ेगा?
क्लास लगेगी 1 दिन की,
मुझे कहता 15 दिन क्लास है।
Stung by the criticism, Delhi and Mumbai police officials say that they will widen the net of police verification. But this is a dogged and time-consuming process. First, the request is sent from the transport department to the concerned police station, where the police verifies the driver's address and talks to the neighbors. The request is then fed to a central police database that tests whether any crimes have been registered against the driver in the state.
Senior police officials admit the system is not perfect.
Since our database is not very scientific and we don't have till today national database also, therefore as far as a man committing crime in another state and getting verification in another state, that creates problem. But as far as Mumbai is concerned, almost it is foolproof.
To plug the leaks, several radio taxi companies use their own security checks.
Knowing whatever is the quality of that police verification, the industry went 2-3 steps further. So incidentally, what we do is, we not only ask for a police verification, we also get a third party verification done, where somebody goes to their home in the local place, as also to their home in their place of ancestral home, and tries to find out their credibility and their credentials from the local police station.
Company se aaya tha koi?
Company se bhi aate hai.
Verify kiya tha?
Company bagair verify kiye, wo hum logon ko meru cab mein entry nahi degi.
Moreover, under the rules, radio taxis have safety backups beyond driver verification.
Already GPS और GPRS activated है.
ठीक है. But आप इसको off कर सकते हैं? मतलब GPS off हो सकता है?
Off नहीं होएगा.
नहीं होता है.
नहीं होएगा. ये off तभी हो सकता है जब गाड़ी बिल्कुल खराब हो जाएगी, चलने के लायक नहीं रहेगी, बैटरी नहीं रहेगा, तभी ये off होएगा.
The ban on Uber and services like it is clearly knee-jerk. They constitute too small a fraction of public transport to make a significant difference. Coming up, how the Uber controversy allows governments to deflect attention away from their deeper failure of making the streets for Indian women any safer.